Having issues with your gallbladder? Well, let's try to save it with some natural and home remedies. That's the topic of today's video. Hey everyone, this is Stephanie from Fast Track to Health Wellness Center. Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, please consider subscribing so I can keep you up to date on the latest in natural health, wellness, and weight loss. So this is part two of a three-part series on the gallbladder. In part one, I discussed the anatomy and physiology of the gallbladder and why it's important. Let's just do a quick recap. So the gallbladder is a small storage sac that stores and secretes bile. Bile is important because bile helps emulsify and digest fat. It also helps remove toxins from the body, so it's very important. It's made in the liver, stored in the gallbladder. So that's the function of it. Some of the symptoms that you can have from gallbladder issues are nausea, belching and burping, and also right-sided shoulder pain and neck pain as well. So let's talk about some things that you can do to help out your gallbladder naturally. So the first thing you can do is eat foods that are really good for your liver and gallbladder and help thin out the bile. Sour foods are especially good for the liver and gallbladder, things like lemon and lime. So you could use some freshly squeezed lemon juice and put that in your water. That's excellent. And vinegar is also really good. That's a great sour food, especially apple cider vinegar. I'm sure you've heard of apple cider vinegar. Everyone and their mother has heard of apple cider vinegar. So that's something that you can do as well. It's good for all areas of digestion. Just take maybe a tablespoon or two, dilute it a little bit in water and get it down either with your meals or on its own. Make a drink out of it, but it's an excellent home remedy and it's a great sour food. Now, greens, especially bitter greens, are also really good for the liver and gallbladder. Things like dandelion greens, arugula, anything that's kind of bitter, that's really, really excellent. Even garlic and things like that. The number one food though, do you know the number one food to help with the liver and gallbladder? It is beets. Yes, beets. So if you're trying to do a low carb diet, you're probably thinking, oh, I can't really eat beets, but beets and beet greens are especially good for thinning out the bile. So that is the number one food that is great for the liver and gallbladder. And in the next video, I'm going to talk about a supplement that we use that's basically concentrated beets that you could take if you don't want to eat beets all the time. So now, foods to avoid. The biggies are ones you've already heard before for other things. You want to avoid processed and refined foods, especially grains and sugar. These are especially bad for the liver and gallbladder. And also, if you're having a lot of issues, you want to avoid alcohol. And you want to avoid trans fats, so these partially hydrogenated types of fats. They're no good for anything, especially for the liver and gallbladder. Now, one last thing I want to mention, you've probably seen this on the internet, something called the gallbladder, or maybe the liver flush, liver or gallbladder flush. Either way, it's an old naturopathic remedy that's been used. Some people think it's great, other people think it's a hoax. It's a method where you follow a certain recipe, and the recipe can vary from person to person, where you don't eat fat for a while, like a day or two, and you eat a lot of apples or drink apple juice. Then, to prepare for the flush, you have a mixture of olive oil and either lemon or grapefruit juice, and you down that with some Epsom salt, or in our clinic, we would use a different product. And then the next day, when you go to the bathroom, the toilet's gonna be filled with stones coming from the gallbladder or the liver. I have tried this myself and I definitely think that it does something, and I always feel better when I do it. Now in my clinic, when I advise people to do it, we use a different product called disodium phosphate, not Epsom salt, because Epsom salt can be very harsh. But in any case, you need something to make sure that you evacuate your bowels the next day. So in any case, you can go online. There's a million recipes for this. It's called the liver gallbladder flush. Another home remedy that you can use to help flush out your liver and your gallbladder. All right, guys, so that's it for today. If you're new here, like I said, please consider subscribing. And in part three of this series, I'm going to get into very specific supplements that you can take either to help save your gallbladder if you're having issues, or if you already have your gallbladder removed, what you need to do now in order to make sure that you're optimal with your digestion and to absorb your fat-soluble vitamins. So stay tuned for part three. All right, guys, I'll see you soon in part three. Thanks and take care. Bye.